In this video, I'm going to teach you how to install Vim and install Copilot and teach it how to exit Vim. GitHub Copilot has been extended to the text editor, which is Neovim. And if you look at the compare Neovim to Vim, I don't really have great answers on that other than that the community's slightly different in their approach on how they set up their environment. So in Vim, you have a VimRC. In Neovim, you have a .vim. Head over to the GitHub Copilot repo and find the Neovim plugin. Now, inside the README, you do have instructions on how to install this. So first, you're going to want to actually install the nightly version of Neovim. This is important because this has the latest and greatest and everything that needs the connections to make this work. Again, this is technical preview for GitHub Copilot, so having the nightly version of Neovim is going to be something you want to use at your own discretion. As well as using Copilot, you'll use on your own discretion. Read the terms and conditions to make sure this is suitable for your day-to-day workflow. Now that that's complete, let's go ahead and check out to see how to install GitHub Copilot in Neovim. Now this is a Vim plugin, and all Vim plugins are associated with GitHub repos. And if you are familiar with how Vim plugins work, they usually use a package manager. But since this is a technical preview, I bet this will change in the future, so I'm just going to simply clone the package into my distro folder, and if anything changes in the future, I'll just delete that and reclone it. So the cool thing about the Vim plugin for GitHub Copilot is that it was authored and supported by Tim Pope. Now, if you have not used Vim or if you're not aware of the Vim community, Tim Pope is a Vim artist, essentially.
Nice.
I thought that was cool, and even cooler, it only took 4 commits to make this work. I'm just kidding. That was a joke. So now that we're set up to use Neovim and leverage the Copilot plugin, why don't we just go ahead and write some code to see how it works? So I already created a JavaScript file to test this out. So let's open that up and run the Copilot setup command. Here in the repo, I just need to add the Copilot setup command. So I'll go ahead and do that. And what this is doing is asking me to authenticate with GitHub to ensure I have access to the technical preview. This is a common practice for GitHub apps and integrations. If you're interested in checking this out, just check out the documentation on how to do this. Now, if you're part of the technical preview, consider sharing your experience in the feedback discussions. The reason for technical preview is that we want to make sure the experience of Copilot is good for all developers who choose to use it. So please take advantage of providing feedback here. So after authenticating, it wants me to agree to the terms. If you wanted to review those terms, they're here in the documentation to read. The TLDR is that the telemetry leverages your experience with Copilot for the AI to learn. And that's exactly what I'm going to be doing, which is going to be teaching it how to exit Vim. Now that I'm authenticated as a GitHub user, which is BDuggy, that's me, hello, why don't we go ahead and write some code? So Copilot does the best when you write comments before you start writing code. And I've got a little note on how to plan FizzBuzz. And since this is a common practice problem for new programmers, Copilot's going to handle this with ease. And already you can see I have a function, which is FizzBuzz. So in the terminal, I'm going to run node practice.js, and so what's funny is that Copilot is a great AI pair programmer, but it's not going to call you out when you forget the console.log. So I need to go back and actually write a console.log so that way we're not just returning strings. So with that fixed, let's go ahead and run it again. And now it works. So this code looks pretty good to go, and let's see if we can auto-complete some other examples. So we're going to get FizzBuzz, and then also going to get the case where, and we're also going to get the case where you return a number whenever the number itself is not divisible by 3 or 5. Cool. Now, I wonder if we can go ahead and add some other use cases. Now, I wonder if I can just write a random number generator, which I think in JavaScript is pretty easy. And of course, Copilot took that with ease as well. And this is exactly a random number. All right, so now that the console log is now mapped to the corresponding function, this is all working, this is great. I think this sort of runs the extent of what we're looking to what to do. Let's go ahead and teach you how to exit Vim. And right off the bat, we already know. Save and quit.
Music paused.
And that's it. It's going to exit Vim on its own. And it's going to even use that exclamation point to... You probably want to see Copilot do something more than just FizzBuzz. So I would love for you to comment below on some common programming problem. The one with the most likes is going to be the one I use in the future video. And if you want to see more Copilot action, check out this next video.
Nice.